What's up, everyone? So we get a lot of comments asking for more audio tools in Filmora, or even for specific sound effects to go with things like the Blockbuster pack. So what maybe most people don't realize is there's so much you could already do with what's already inside the program. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make the best use of the sound effects inside Filmora to make your video content even better. So what you need to do if you don't already have the program is go download it from filmora.wondershare.com. Alright, let's get into it. So for this example, we have a skit that we already filmed, edited, and added music and visual effects to. In this video, we're going to take the sound effects that are already inside Filmora and make it way better.
Yes.
Darn it! I don't want to play anymore.
Come on. C4.
Oh.
Was it a hit?
So for the purpose of this tutorial, I've taken out the music and the sound effects. So let's have a listen of what that's like.
Miss.
Darn it! I don't want to play anymore.
Come on. C4.
Oh.
Was it a hit?
Alright, so now that I have Filmora open, the first thing to note is where all the sound effects can be located. So under the music tab, under sound effects, that's where all the sounds in this video are found. And to start the cinematic sequence off right, I've decided to use the record fuzz sound. And what I've decided to do is to change its pitch because I just felt like it sounded better. So I changed the pitch up to. And then what you notice is that the sound actually goes beyond where our actual skit starts. So what I want to do is reduce that timing of that sound to just around the time where Matt's eyes show up on the screen and add a bit of a fade out on the sound so that it blends into the next section. So let's hear what that sounds like. Alright, we got some ambience going on. I think all it's really missing is some impact. So what I'm going to do is take the atomic bomb sound found in the sound effects and add it to the part of the title screen that actually has the text show up. And this sound is a little bit long too, so I might want to shorten it and add a fade out for smooth transition. Alright, let's see what that sounds like. All right, that's getting pretty good. Now when Matt's eyes show up, we want some more impact. So what I'm gonna do is take the cinematic horn sound and put it right at the start of our skit. So we have another part there. We want the cinematic horn sound to cut off when JJ's eyes come on. And we want to add another cinematic horn sound for her little scene, or for her shot. So what we're going to do in order to make these match, we're going to open up the cinematic horn sound by double clicking on it, and we're going to give it a bit of a fade out. And we're going to also copy that sound and paste it where JJ's eyes come in, probably around there, so we have to cut it a bit shorter. And since the two cinematic horn sounds are the same, I don't necessarily want that. I want a bit of emotion. So I'm going to change the second sound to have one pitch less. I'm going to fade it in so that it's a bit smoother. Let's see what that sounds like. So you might notice that there's like a mouse clicking sound. That's okay. You can play around with the fades. Maybe the fade out of the first sound and the fade in of the second sound to get that, to remove it as much as possible. So let's hear what the sequence sounds like up until now.
Darn it! I don't want to play anymore.
Come on.
So this is the next part where I wanted to add a sound effect. When my eyebrows go up and down, I think it's a good part for comedic relief. So we're going to add that car horn sound in the sound effects library. Place it underneath the part where my eyebrows go up. It's almost there, but I think we might need to change the timing a little bit. Let's make it 1:02 in the duration section. See what that sounds like. There's still a bit of a click. I think that's okay. Filmora's just getting loaded. There, that works pretty fine. You can tell that the sound effect matches my movements.
C4.
And then this part,
where
Matt explodes. You know, that's the blockbuster effect that most people want sound effects for, but they don't realize that we already have explosions inside the sound effects pack. And you can modify these inside Filmora to match these different effects. So I'm going to take that explosion sound, put it under the part where Matt explodes. There you go. Maybe we can change this to fade out a little bit so that it more smoothly transitions into the next shot. See what that sounds like.
Oh,
you know what? Maybe it needs to be timed a bit better. I'm going to zoom in a little bit closer. Get close to the part where the explosion happens. Oh, I can see it's just a bit earlier than I had the sound. There we go. Now it's on time.
Was it a hit?
There you go. We pretty much added a bunch of sound effects into the video. So you might have to play around with these sounds a little bit more in the audio editor. When you double click on a sound effect, you have all these different options. You know, in order to really make your audio seamless with your video, you'll probably want to play with the audio effects duration, maybe change the pitch of the different clips, as well as the volume. Because for example, in this scene, the cinematic horn sound is a lot louder than some of the other sounds, so I might turn down its volume and turn up the volume of the ambiance in the intro, for example. But that's really all you need to do to enhance the sound effects and the sound in your video. That's it for me. Thanks for watching. As you can see, Filmora already has tons of audio tools and sound effects that can really enhance the production value of your videos. And if that sound effects library is too small, we created a whole nother website where you can download and search from hundreds of different sound effects. All right, thanks for watching. Ciao.